but I'm of absolutely no importance at all to forestry. I'm just helping out. I'm a PhD student at the Women's Student School. My name is Tracy McCowan, and my research has to do with agriculture, ethics, and market mechanisms, so really not much to do with this. Our first speaker this afternoon is Elise Schadler, who is the coordinator of community-based learning for the Rubenstein School of Environment and Natural Resources at the University of Vermont, and the community involvement coordinator for Vermont's Urban and Community Forestry Program. She hails from the Midwest, discovered her passions for the city trees and environmental stewardship while working in urban New Jersey, and received her master's in science from natural resources from the University of Vermont. Elise.
Thank you.
Thanks everyone for coming. The first presentation after lunch, drowsy, so I'm trying to jazz it up a little fuzzy. So I wanted to Carl and Jim had asked me to give this presentation to kind of highlight some of the ways in which the Rubenstein School is already engaging with students. You know, as Mike mentioned in his presentation, it is definitely there are a lot of possibilities to work with students, and we're doing a lot already in the So just to give you a little bit of context, Rubenstein School over right in the Aiken building right across the way, we have about 600 undergrads, about 130 grad students, and we have really, over the years, decided that experiential education, experiential learning opportunities for students is a really attractive way for students to get some applied skills in addition to the knowledge that they're getting from the academic content of the class. So we have an Office of Experiential Learning, so an internship coordinator who deals with research, study abroad, and internships. And then since 2007, we've had someone in my position, which is coordinating the service learning classes. And what service learning really is at a base level, is taking a class and having a community project that is directly connected to the academic content of that class. So in service learning world, we talk about the three R's. There's the rigorous, so it's an academically rigorous class that has reciprocity, so community partners and students are getting a direct benefit from engaging in a project. And then there's reflection, so the students are asked to critically reflect about how the experience relates to their own lives, to the world around them, to the community partner, and the benefit that it provides. So we actually, we're pretty much, Rubenstein School is a leader in service learning, offering service learning classes across campus. About 40% of all classes that are offered as service learning classes at UVM come from the Rubenstein School, even though we're one of the smallest units on campus. So Interim Dean John Erickson has put together a draft strategic plan this year, and as you see, the third of our main goals through the strategic plan is to engage more community partners across for the full mission of the school. And so right now is a really exciting time that we are really thinking about different ways to engage students in working with the community, working with partners like the state and like the MC. So I'm not going to go through read all of these, but these are just a couple of, thinking about the service learning and community partnerships are, it's a way to benefit the community and community partners and the state and university by actually engaging students in providing data, providing project deliverables. But in terms of the effects on students and the impact on students, these classes, from my experience being involved as a teaching assistant, as a lab instructor, co-teaching or a senior capstone course, and also coordinating with other faculty and students, it's a really, really impactful way for them to engage with learning and to really feel connected to the field that they're working in, being the environmental field, and to feel like they're really gaining specific and direct skills that they will be able to use out once they start trying to find a job. So we see a lot of really profound learning moments happen through these service learning projects. So I'm just gonna quickly, I was asked to come in and talk and give some models about how what types of service learning projects are happening, what types of products these students are able to hand over to our community partners what types of different models there might be if you or someone you know might be interested in looking at teaching instruction. So this is just to kind of illustrate the point that I made before about there's, you know, a lot of the service learning classes, these are the bottom bar is the classes being offered from the Rubenstein School, and then the top is classes offered campus-wide. So you see we've been increasing over time, and now we are offering about 40% of all those classes. And the projects and classes I've decided to talk about are all in some way related to forests. We have over 150 different projects are happening every year. But these are just a couple that I decided to highlight. In our Restoration for Altered Ecosystems course, which has traditionally been taught by Professor Bill Keaton, who's around here somewhere today, the students in the class actually take a full semester to walk through assessing an area in the past couple years that's been a riparian area that is a lot of mostly converted farmland. And they actually go through the process of writing the whole restoration plan and then implementing that plan at the end of the semester by doing a planting day on the field. So their partner for the past couple years has been the Nature Conservancy, but I know we've been approached by Vermont Land Trust and a couple of other groups that are also interested in taking this model and using this whole cohort of 40 plus students to do this big restoration effort. Cecilia Dix, who's also around here somewhere and was actually my thesis advisor, teaches a community-based natural resource management class. And the students in this class are exposed to a number of different project formats and ultimately choose a small 3 to 4 week community service learning project to do independently. A lot of students end up choosing something around invasives. These two projects involved students organizing invasives removals days. We had a group of students that went to the Berrytown Green and interviewed farmers markets participants and vendors about the value of community green spaces and the value that provides to their overall sense of community and connection to nature. Forest Ecosystem Health is a course taught by Dr. Kimberly Wallen. We've had a variety of partners looking, and this class is really focused on forest health, but the community service learning portion has been really focused on invasive forest pests. So last year we did a street tree inventory of South Burlington's ash trees and inventoried over 600 ash trees in mostly new developments along the public right-of-way. So this is a project that was really helpful, and South Burlington actually used this data to develop an Emerald Ash Borer preparedness plan that they, their arborist is kind of putting final touches on now. This is a poster that's up in the other room. Jen Pontius's Applied Environmental Statistics class has used the Vermont Modern Cooperative's data to kind of actually mine the data and figure out what it all means. And so they're really learning the concepts in the class by using real data and then being able to present it. Measurements and Mapping is a course that has been taught by a number of different folks. Walter Pullman is one of them. Emily Brodsky and Zach Espalanda are both grad students with me, and now they're teaching in the Rubenstein School. And this class, again, is another one where students break up into small groups and they go off and work with different partners to do some project around taking forest measurements and doing mapping projects. So we had two ash inventories that were done, one in Richford and one actually in Essex Junction, where they found some trees that they were really worried about. We were immediately able to contact the Chittenden County Forester, get him out there, check on the trees. It was not about ash borer, thank goodness. Nikepdai, Parks and Rec, has been a partner in this class for a long time. They often do interpretive maps. The students will make Google Maps that the users can use that are more doing that interpretive piece that David Mears was talking about is so important, like taking the science, taking all that work, and being able to translate it to the public. I'm not going to talk about all these projects because we've been running out of time, but NR206 is our senior capstone course. So every single senior in the Rubenstein School does a semester-long project that they choose. So we give them a suite of 30 plus different projects that range from everything. there's a whole suite of different projects, but a lot of them end up, a lot, especially the forestry students, do forest-based work. We had some students work at Jericho Research Forest and do a full survey for black ash, and then do a community workshop on uses for black ash and management for black ash. We had a group of students do a full assessment of the State House Forest, the forest parcel that lies right behind the State House. They did wildlife monitoring, carbon values, they did a forest inventory, they did tours with state legislators, and brought some high school students out to teach them about forest monitoring methods. So those are just some examples. And then the last one I'll just mention is NR1, which Jim Duncan is going to be presenting about in the next session, which is the first class that any NR students come in into the Robinson School take, and they've been involved with iTree and doing a full urban forest assessment. So, as I have 1 minute left, I just want to quickly talk about the other half of my job, which is with the Vermont Urban and Community Forestry Program. So I'm halfway funded by the Rubenstein School, but my background is in urban forestry, and so I work with the program, and two of my teammates are in this room, if you have them here. The mission of the program is really to promote stewardship of urban and rural landscapes to enhance the quality of life in Vermont communities. And we've really been able to leverage this position to get a lot of work done and increase our capacity to provide technical assistance to municipalities, assistance doing projects that they frankly don't have the resources or the manpower to get done. And a lot of that is around inventory work. Last year was the first year that we engaged in this partnership, and we ended up having about 9 total projects throughout the course of the year that were somehow related to urban forestry. And this year we're looking at this semester, just the fall semester, a lot more. We also secured funding to get 6 interns throughout the course of the year, so I've been working with 3 interns from the Rubenstein School working on specific projects around urban forestry, and we'll have 3 more in the spring. So the point that I'm making is that this is a model that's really worked well for urban community forestry. It's working well for Rubenstein School, and we would love to see this expanding in the future, and that experiential learning, these types of service learning opportunities, as well as internships, are really important for healthy landscapes, community partnerships that are rich and beneficial, and experiences for these students who really are wanting to, a lot of them, stay in Vermont and be our future resource managers. Any questions?
So what is the best way if we have sort of like really an internship idea, project ideas that we would love students to work on? What's the best way to?
Yeah, get in touch with me and then I'll connect you with our internship coordinator. We actually have been having a series of meetings, Anna, our internship coordinator, and myself, with David Mears and Pat Berry, Deb Markowitz, and then actually tomorrow we'll be meeting with Mike Snyder. So we are really trying to strategically think about best ways to provide that really structured connection.
Yeah. So Elise, we are trying to get field map group student could do some inventory work for us in 3 parcels that we're going to be incorporating the amended Mountain Landscape Management.
Mm-hmm.
So would you coordinate that, or would you
better? No, so the field naturalist, that's a graduate program, and
yeah, okay.
Dean Wong,
yeah,
and Jeff. So Dean,
yep,
Dean is a big proponent for experiential learning.
Yeah, and I have interacted with,
yeah,
him. I didn't know if you were coordinating.
No, just most of the classes that I'm coordinating are the
undergrad
classes.
Okay.
But while there are a lot of grad classes that do, the faculty that teaches are pretty versed in,
yeah, sure,
in the way that works.
Yeah, 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 okay.